Fertility Care, the IVF Center here in Orlando, Florida. Hope you're all doing well. Those of you in the Northeast, we're praying that you weathered that awful storm. And sorry we're a little bit late. It's 1 o'clock here on the East and got behind with some patients, so I apologize. Over the last few weeks, we've been seeing more patients, or several patients at least, with premature ovarian failure. Now that's an older term, but it means that the ovaries have essentially stopped functioning in terms of producing eggs. And 1% of women less than age 40 will be given this diagnosis. All right? The average age of menopause in the United States is 51. To review, women are born with all the eggs they're ever going to have, 1 to 2 million at birth, and then when you've gone down to puberty, or you've gone down to 200 to 400,000 at puberty, hundreds get used every month, only one makes it to ovulation, the rest die off. So hundreds of eggs are being used up. In patients with premature ovarian failure, or the newer term, primary ovarian insufficiency, there is an acceleration in the loss of eggs until they have no further periods. So we diagnose this by no periods for three months with an FSH level above 30. FSH is the pituitary hormone that is getting feedback from the ovary. And if the ovary is not responding by making estrogen from those growing eggs, the brain says, hey, where's the estrogen? Let me give more signals. So high levels of FSH are diagnostic of ovarian failure if you've waited about 3 months with no periods. So when you get this diagnosis, we want to take a look at why something like this could have occurred. And we look at other hormone-producing organs, because often it is an autoimmune issue. So we check the thyroid, we check the adrenal gland, and we also check your chromosomes. The complete karyotype for women, it should be 46XX. We check for a mutation on the X chromosome called fragile X. Fragile X is associated with premature ovarian failure. It's also the reason for the most common inherited form of mental retardation. So once we make this diagnosis, and believe me, it's devastating diagnosis to provide a woman, it's not final. In other words, once this diagnosis is made, 50% of women can have sporadic periods. Of those, 5 to 10% get pregnant. We had a patient a few years ago who came with the diagnosis, and I did an ultrasound on her for our first visit. She had a cyst on her ovary, and I said, you know, I don't want to get your hopes up, but it looks like the ovary just ovulated not too many days ago. She never got her period after that visit, and she ended up having spontaneous twins, and they were born, and she has a wonderful family, and that's just very, very exciting for her. So things like that can happen. Typically, the treatment for premature ovarian failure is egg donation. Now, we're doing a study here called Ovarian Rejuvenation, where we infuse into the ovary, right here in the office, platelet-rich plasma. Your blood is spun, and we concentrate the blood into the growth factors in the plasma. And so we infuse that into the ovary, and the hope is that it replenishes or regrows ovarian follicles to allow for the resumption of periods and potential pregnancy. Now, when I said that there's no further eggs when you make this diagnosis, there could be, there are some eggs, but they're so quiescent and so quiet that they are not responding. But you could never say never, of course. There's always that chance of sporadic ovulation. So if you get that diagnosis from your OB-GYN, come to see us or another reproductive endocrinologist, wherever you are. You get the evaluation to check for other autoimmune issues. You check the genetics. And then you talk about really options. If the goal is not to proceed with childbearing, then weight-bearing exercise and calcium and vitamin D are important for bone preservation. Potentially birth control pills, low dose birth control pills, particularly to reduce hot flashes, because the low estrogen can trigger that. And it may help with bone mineral density as well, preserving that. So just let us know what your options are interested in. We're always available to you. And have a fantastic week, and we will see you next week.